There was a new glitch found in DK64 recently, which I'll be referring to as stored location collision clipping. I've linked the video of the find by Znernicus in the description for those that want to see it. I figured I'd do a quick explanation of stored location collision clipping, just so there is an easy to understand resource out there. I'm going to explain what current versus stored locations are, and why pausing is necessary for this to work. After that, I'll explain why the glitch works. Let's start with current location. Your current location is the XYZ coordinates at which your character can be found. If you take a look at the left side of my screen, my current location is the XYZ values found near the top left. Your stored locations are a bit trickier. There's a ton I can say about this, but I'll keep it short. Your character essentially has two extra sets of coordinates that are used when performing certain actions, like climbing a tree or throwing oranges in third-person view. If you take a look at the left side of my screen again, my stored locations are shown near the bottom left, with one set being Bone Array 1 and the second set being Bone Array 2. These stored locations are normally about the same as your current location, but can become completely disjointed from your current location in a few scenarios, like after performing tag barrel storage. With all of this out of the way, let's get on with the explanation. You won't be able to see Lanky as he is invisible because of tag barrel storage, but you'll hear him. Probably. I have Lanky in this corner here, shown with my mouse. Important things to note are that I'm tight to the corner with a wall on my right and a wall in front. I'm going to pause here to bring up the pause menu, and more importantly, to force both of my stored locations to update to my current location. Now that my stored locations are set, I'm going to move to another corner in another room. Watch the left side of my screen, and you'll notice that my current location is updating, but neither of my stored locations are. The important thing to note about the corner that I'm at now is that there is a wall on the left and a wall behind me relative to where I paused. All it takes now is attacking the physical corner in front of me. Doing so should let me clip out of bounds. Like so. So, why does this happen? You may have already figured it out by now, but if you haven't, here's the explanation. The game uses the collision around your current location, as well as the collision around your stored locations when you perform an attack. We can abuse this fact by setting our stored locations in a corner using pause, then moving our character into another corner that ideally has two walls that the stored location corner did not have. In this scenario, recall that the stored location corner had a wall in front of us and a wall to the right of us. The current location corner completes this sort of box around our character by having a wall to the left of us and a wall behind us, relative to where I paused. Now we have effectively created a box that is too small for our character. By attacking and moving in the direction of the current location corner, we are able to clip through as the walls that the stored location corner provides will not let us move backwards, so the game pushes our character forwards and out of bounds. A quick rule of thumb for this is always pause in the corner opposite to the corner you want to clip through. Hopefully that explains stored location collision clipping well enough. If not, or if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching.